SPC for Excel. Simple but powerful. What makes it so simple? That's how easy it is to make a chart using the software. For example, suppose you have a customer who wants to know your CPK value, your process capability of your process. Simple to do. Simply enter your data into an Excel spreadsheet. Select CPK from the SPC for Excel ribbon. All you have to do is enter the name for the chart. We'll call it CPK. Then your specification limits. I'm going to use 70 for a lower, 100 for a nominal, upper spec 130, only need one. Select OK. And your process capability chart is generated with all the statistics you need to share with your customer. Or perhaps your customer wants to know that your process is in statistical control. Go back, enter your data again into an Excel spreadsheet, as we've said. Select the type of chart you want to use. We're going to do an individuals chart here. Select OK. And just enter the name of the chart. We'll just call it XMR. Select OK, and you have your control chart generated. Red points are out of control. Or maybe you're monitoring return goods, and it reasons for returns, and you want to separate the vital few from the trivial many with a Pareto diagram. Again, enter your data into an Excel spreadsheet. Select the Pareto diagram. Enter the name of the chart. We'll call it defects. Select OK, and you have your Pareto diagram to separate the vital few from the trivial many. That's how easy it is to make charts using the SPC for Excel program. Simple. Enter your data, select the chart you want to use, enter a name, select OK, and you have your chart. But what makes SPC for Excel so powerful? Two things. One is the options you have, and then the variety of statistical techniques is the others. Each chart is easy to update with new data, plus each chart has many options. For example, if you go to the CPK chart that we just did, you come in and you can see your options down here. You have options to add the average. You have the options to add plus or minus 3 sigma lines. You can add a target and get a CPM value. You can remove outliers, or you can transform the data using a Box-Cox transformation or a Johnson transformation. With the control charts, you have just as many options as well. For example, you have the options to change your out-of-control test, change the formatting that you use, to do a Box-Cox transformation, to tie a process capability chart to that, to have manual control limits as well. And of course the Pareto diagram has options as well. You have the option to have another category or to add or remove the cumulative line. So lots of options. So one thing that makes it so powerful is the option. The other is the variety of techniques. We have Pareto charts, histograms, 27 different control charts, non-normal process capability, regression, measurement system analysis with gauge R&R, ANOVA, data transformation and distribution fitting, and all sorts of hypothesis testing. And there's great help to help you understand how to use the program. So SPC for Excel, simple but powerful. If you haven't tried the demo, please download it. Thank you for taking the time to watch the video.